Today we're going to talk about winding our bobbins. And right here on the table, I have several bobbins that you can look at. The bobbins go in the bottom of the sewing machine right here. So right here in the bottom, it's where the bobbin goes, and it's the bottom thread of your stitching when you sew. So when you look at several bobbins, you want to make sure you're using the correct bobbin for your sewing machine. So sewing machines come with different size bobbins, and this one, if you can tell, are the same size. They're flat on the top, they're the same width through here, and they fit the baby lock machine. This bobbin is much smaller, it's concaved at the top, and it does not fit this. It's just a standard bobbin that you might buy at the store. So when you're looking for bobbins and to wind your bobbin for your machine, make sure you're using the bobbin that goes with your machine to get the correct stitch. Okay, and let's also look at quality of winding your bobbin. Now, even though this bobbin is the right bobbin, we have a loose thread hanging out. When the bobbin's going around in the machine, that can get caught and cause your stitching to break. So you always want to make sure you have nothing that's hanging out as you're winding the bobbin. So this is an incorrectly wound bobbin. Here's another one that is incorrectly wound. You can see all the threads hanging out. You can see it's not even and smooth. You do not want to use a bobbin like this because it will break, it will cause you frustration. And so you want just a nice, evenly wound bobbin that's wound evenly up and down without all of this like tangled mess hanging out. Here's a bobbin that is correctly wound. Here's the thread that comes out. It comes out easily. It's nice and smooth. And we can use this to wind our bobbin or to put in the sewing machine. So we want to wind our bobbin to make it look like this. So I'm going to go through the steps on how to wind your bobbin in your baby lock machine. First off, let's talk about the bobbin and the make of the bobbin. And I'm hoping that you can see there's a little indention here, right here. It's a little groove, and the groove is there also. So if you look at the little groove right here, it matches up. Let's walk over to the machine. It matches up to a little spring casing that's located here. And you want to match up your bobbin to the spring casing. And here's the spring casing, and there's the groove. And if you match it up, your bobbin goes right down into the bobbin case, or the bobbin winder, I'm sorry. So anyway, you take your bobbin winder and you go ahead and you move it over. And when you move it over, it locks it where the flywheel doesn't go around, and it just winds the bobbin, so it like puts the mechanism here to turn the bobbin. Okay, that's the first thing you do. The next thing you're gonna do is put the thread on the sewing machine. So I have some thread here. We're gonna put it on the sewing machine. We're gonna put this bull cap on, and we're going to thread it as to use the bobbin and to wind it. So we're going to go through here to one. If you watch the video on how to thread the machine, we're using the same number, but we're just going to do one, and we're following the dotted lines this time. So it's one, dotted line, number two at the top. It's a dotted line. So the thread goes this direction towards where the bobbin is. And then we're going to go here, and at the top right here, there's like a little screw, and it's like a tension that holds the thread in place. And you want to go around this direction, this way, to get the thread in. Now, I'm going to hold the thread. I'm going to wind the thread around clockwise 4 or 5 times. And there's a little groove right here on the gray base. I put my thread in right here. I pull the thread back and it cuts the thread off. Now, the great thing about this machine, it has a stop and start button. And we're going to use that to wind our bobbin. So to use that, I'm going to unplug the foot pedal from the machine. And I'm going to adjust the speed control. If it's here, it's slower. If it's here, it's faster. I'm going to put it on fast. I'm going to hit start. And then we're going to watch as the machine winds a fabulous bobbin. And it's going to go. It's going as fast as it can. It's nice and smooth and straight. That's what you're looking for. It's not getting caught on anything. If you look on here on the digital screen, it says winding bobbin thread. Now, as the bobbin gets full, it's going to start slowing down. And you're going to hear it get slower. It's getting slower. And then it stops. And that's when you hit the stop button. Now, all you have to do is take the bobbin off the bobbin winder. Put your foot pedal and reconnect it back. And when you release this, it's ready to sew. Trim your thread. And now, easy peasy, you have a perfectly wound bobbin that's even. So let's go over the rules. You want to use a bobbin that's the right size. If I match these up, you can see one is taller. So make sure whatever machine that you have at home or you have here at school, you want to use the right bobbin for the right machine. If you use the wrong one, it doesn't go through the tension bobbin control and it can lead to skip stitches, breaking of your thread. You also want to make sure it's evenly wound without any strings hanging down that can get caught when you are sewing. Okay. I hope that I've made this really easy for you.